Hi friends, this is the lecture number two. Today is the GATE lecture. We will solve some previous year questions in this. Today we have just started this topic. This is the differential equation. Okay, in this differential equation we will use some topics, and I will clear the topics, and after then I will also solve some questions that has come in your previous year GATE exam. So here we are using the dy by dx. Actually, what is y and what is x? Again, I am just explaining this y, this is the function of x. It means that this is just like this, and this is the variable. Just by moving, okay, my lower part, that is x, and my upper part, that is y. Whenever you are moving your body, okay, suppose you are walking in this condition, this is your upper portion and this is your lower portion. So when I am just walking, so with respect to x, whatever the changes in y, that is the, that rate is called the differentiation, derivative. Okay, so this is, here we are just not explaining it. So d means derivative. It means that d means derivative. You are finding the derivative. The application is acceleration, velocity. Okay, you also already, we have also studied in physics, we are using in every or real life. Okay, so now today the differential equation, that is also polynomial. Just I am writing the polynomial px is equal to x ki power n a n x ki power n plus a n minus 1 x ki power n minus 1 up to so on a1 x plus a0, where a n minus 1 a1 a0, these are the coefficient. Okay, so you can see that these are belonging to real number or any number, but this x, this is the variable. We have written x to the power n. This polynomial, its degree is n, it's totally depend on the power of x. Okay, so its degree is power. It means that degree is equal to power. Okay, degree is equal to power. Okay, now second one. So in the differential equation, if I will write this x is equal to dy by dx, in this condition it will be just look like this, a ki power n dy by dx ki power n plus a ki power n minus 1 dy by dx ki power n minus 1, similarly up to so on. So you can see that this is also polynomial, but if we have changed in place of x dy by dx, then it is just looking like this differential equation. Okay, so in the differential equations, if we have written this, if we have written dy by dx, what is the meaning of this? After then I have written dy upon dx cube. What is the meaning of this? It means that we have differentiate this y one time. We have differentiate this y one time. Here we have differentiate this y. This is the function. We have differentiate three times. Okay, so the derivative. Okay, so this is the order. How many times you have differentiate? The highest derivative is the order. And what is about the degree? The second question is, what about the degree? The power of highest order is the degree. The power of highest order is the degree. Okay, so now I will explain one question that has come in your GATE exam. Okay, here you can see that this question number third, we are just taking this question number third, it has come. Okay, already we have also discussed that this differential equation, this is the polynomial. Okay, it means that polynomial power, it's belong to the natural number. Okay, so if it is belonging to the natural number, it will be never fractional. Fractional means 1 upon 2, 3 upon 2, it will be never. Okay, in this condition it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like this. Now this is the question number, this, it has come in your GATE exam last year, you can check. Okay, now this question, you have del cube y upon del x cube, okay, plus 4 square root dy upon dx ki power 3 plus y square is equal to 0. You have this question. Okay, Now you can see that here you have fraction. The power is the fraction, so you have to remove it. This is your task. So it means that this will come here and this will come here. So you have del cube y upon del x cube plus y square is equal to square root. This is square root means dy by dx ki power 3 ki power 1 upon 2. Its power is 1 upon 2 because of square root. Now this 1 upon 4, this 1 upon 4 will come here. Okay. Now our task to remove this one, to remove this 1 upon 2. Okay. Whenever you will remove this 1 upon 2, then you have to square both sides. It means that. So it will be 4 4 is 16. Okay. Then this is del cube y upon del x cube plus y square whole square, okay, is equal to dy by dx ki power 3. Okay. Now you can see that there is no fractional. Okay. If there is no fractional, then you can find the order and degree in this condition. So now you have to open it. You know that a plus b whole square is equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab. Okay, you have to use the formula. And after then 1 upon 16 a square del cube y upon del x cube whole square, okay, plus y ki power 4 plus multiplication of into this del cube y upon del x cube into this a square b square 2 into a into b, okay, this is equal to this dy by dx whole cube. Okay, this is your answer. Now what is the order? The highest derivative is del cube. Where you have differentiate this y more times. Here also you can see that we have differentiate this y 3 times, and also here we have differentiate this y 3 times. So the order is 3. The order is equal to 3. It means that now degree. Now where you have power 1, but here you have power 2. So you will take the biggest one. The biggest one is the 2, not 1. So it means that your degree is 2. Your degree is equal to 2. This is your answer. Okay. So you have to remember there will be no fractional. Okay. Because of the polynomial. Okay. Now the second question, so your answer, it will be order is equal to 3 and degree is equal to 2. So your answer is this. This question, it has come in your GATE exam. Okay, this question. Now I am taking another question. Another question is this. He is also asking this question. It has also come in your GATE exam. Okay, I am just erasing it. Okay. Now the second question. Second question, they have asked this one. 1 plus dy by dx. 1 plus dy by dx power whole square. Okay. Again, power 3 is equal to d square y upon dx square whole square. Okay. Now you have to check that where you have derivate means you have differentiate more times. You can see that here we have differentiate 2 times and here we have differentiate only 1 times. So we will use this one. Okay, there is no fractional part. Okay, no problem. So the order is equal to, it means that order is equal to 2 and its power is equal to 2 and degree, its power is equal to also 2. So your answer is equal to 2 and 2. This is your answer. Okay, very very simple. The third question, that it has come in your GATE 2010. In this question they have asked the first one is second order. This is this differential equation del cube f upon del neta cube plus f upon 2 del cube f upon del neta square is equal to 0. So second order, this is the second order non-linear ODE, third order non-linear ODE, third order linear ODE and mixed order non-linear ODE. What is the definition of linear and non-linear? Okay. Whenever you have any function f of x is equal to x square plus 2. Okay. If you have any function just like this, this x plus 2, okay, so I am just talking like this, x plus 2, if the power of any variable is 1, in that function, then you will say that this is the linear. Linear means straight line. Okay, straight line, any straight line. This straight line, it is representing linear. And non-linear means you have any such type of curve. So curve, it can possible if you have a non-linear form, means degree may be more than one. Okay, if degree is greater than one, then you will say that this is the non-linear. If degree is one, then you will say that this is the linear. So he has asked that this differential equation is linear or non-linear. Okay, so degree is more than one, how can possible? If x into x, then its degree is 2. If x into x, its degree is 3. Okay, you can see. So whenever you are multiplying any variable, same variable or any variable, if you are multiplying x into y, so this is the non-linear form because of two variable you have multiplied. Its degree is 1, its degree is 1. 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. Okay, here also 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. 1 plus 1 is equal to 3. So it means that you can say that x cube, this is non-linear and this is also non-linear and this is also non-linear. Now here, in this differential equation, you can see that this is del square upon del theta square and you multiply it with f. It means that if you will put del f upon del n is equal to p, suppose I am just taking, this is the polynomial, okay, I am taking del f upon del theta is equal to p. So if we are just thinking that this is the variable into variable, f is also variable, it means that 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. In this condition, you multiplied by this, in this condition this is the non-linear form. Okay, so this is the non-linear form, this is wrong, non-linear form, 3 are correct. Now what is this? He is asking that this is order 2 or order 3. Now we have differentiated, the highest derivative, that is 3, the highest derivative is 3, so it you have differentiated 3 times, so this is the third order non-linear ODE. Okay, this is the third order non-linear ODE. You must also know about the difference between ODE and PDE, ordinary differential equation and partial differential equation. Already we have discussed, go in the previous lecture. Okay, we have already uploaded what is the difference between partial and what is the difference between ordinary differential equation. Okay, so these questions we have solved. Okay, now we are coming in second topic. The first topic, that is the variable separable. Whenever you are just finding the solution of any differential equation, okay, so how to find the solution? So there are many ways to find the solutions. So here we are already discussing about the A topic. In the next lecture we will also discuss on the other topics. Okay, here we are discussing on some topics and also we will solve the gate questions. So the first question, variable separable. So first question, we are taking this one, x square 1 plus y dy by dx is equal to plus 1 minus x y square is equal to 0. So you have this question. So separable, variable separable means you have to put this x dx with x and dy with y. Now you can see that this is your question. Okay, you have x square 1 plus y dy by dx is equal to, this will come here, minus 1 minus x y square. Okay, now this is y square, so it will come here, and this is dx, it will come here. In this condition your answer, it will be 1 plus y upon y square into dy is equal to minus 1 minus x upon, this will come here, x square into dx. So dx, we have separate the dx here and we separate the dy here. All the dy it has come here, all dx it has come here. That is the variable separable. Okay, so now, so this x square it has come here. Now we will differentiate it. Okay, at first I will separate it, 1 upon y square plus 1 upon y into dy is equal to minus 1 upon x square माइनस माइनस प्लस वन अपॉन एक्स इंटू डी एक्स. ओके नाउ आफ्टर देन वी हैव टू इंटीग्रेट देन वी विल गेट द सॉल्यूशंस. सो इट मींस दैट यू विल इंटीग्रेट. सो इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ वन अपॉन वाई स्क्वायर डी वाई प्लस इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ वन अपॉन वाई डी वाई इज इक्वल टू माइनस इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ वन अपॉन एक्स स्क्वायर डी एक्स एंड प्लस वन अपॉन एक्स डी एक्स इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ दिस. ओके सो हेयर नेगेटिव. ओके सो आफ्टर देन दिस इज नेगेटिव एंड दिस इज पॉजिटिव. ओके दैट इज करेक्ट. नाउ व्हाट इज दिस इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ वाई की पावर एन. इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ वाई पावर एन इज इक्वल टू एन प्लस वन अपॉन एन प्लस वन. ओके सो इन दिस कंडीशन इट विल कम अबव. ओके वाई की पावर माइनस टू y की पावर माइनस टू अपॉन माइनस टू प्लस वन. इन दिस कंडीशन योर आंसर इट विल बी वन अपॉन y एंड दिस इज y की पावर माइनस वन. सो इन दिस कंडीशन इंटीग्रेशन यू हैव टू फाइंड द इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ वन अपॉन y dy. देन आफ्टर देन यू हैव टू फाइंड इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ वन अपॉन x स्क्वायर dx एंड इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ वन अपॉन x dx. दैट इज वेरी सिंपल. ओके सो नाउ आई विल सॉल्व वन गेट क्वेश्चन. ओके दिस ऑल्सो क्वेश्चन इट हैज कम इन योर गेट एग्जाम. The first gate question, it has come from the separable of variable. Okay. The first question, they have asked if this, you can solve it. This is very easy. Okay. If yx is equal to yx is the solution. Is the solution of differential equation y y dash is equal to 8x y 0 is equal to 2 y 0 is equal to 2 then the absolute value of then y 2 is equal to. He is asking this question. It has come in gate 2018. This is 2018. Okay, gate 2 marks. Okay, 4 2 marks they have asked. Okay, you can see that here we can separate x and y. This is the variable of separable. They will never write solve this question by the help of variable or separable or linear form or exact form. They will never write. So you have this y dash means a dy by dx y. dy by dx is equal to 8x. You have this solution. Okay. So after then you have to separate y into dy is equal to 8x into dx. Okay. After then you have to separate. Now you have to integrate both side. In this condition your answer it will be y square upon 2 is equal to 8x square upon 2 plus c. Okay. In this condition, after then you have to multiply. Okay, y square multiply by 2 is equal to 8x square plus 2c. This is your answer. Now, what they have given us? When x is equal to 0, then your y is equal to 2. When x is equal to 0, then your y is equal to 2. Okay, I will solve. 1 minute. So your y is equal to square root plus minus 8x square plus 2c. This is your y. Okay. When x is equal to 0, then y is equal to 2. When x is equal to 0, y is equal to 2. Y is equal to 2 when x is equal to 0 plus minus 2c. Okay. Now square root both sides. So 2 is equal to plus minus square root 2c, square root both side, 4 is equal to plus minus both will cancel and after then square root means 2c you will get. So c is equal to 2. Your answer is c is equal to 2. Now you have to put this value here. So your answer it will be y square is equal to 8x square plus 2 into 2 is equal to 4. Okay. So your answer is 2 into 2 is equal to 4. Now again he has asked y0. He is asking what about y2? When you are putting in place of x2, then what your answer? What about y? Okay. So again, y is equal to plus minus square root 8x² + 4, okay? So now y is equal to plus minus square root 8, you have to put 2 in place of x. 2 to the 4, 8 4 is 32, 32 plus 4 is equal to 36, 36, it means that you are getting y is equal to plus minus 36 means 6. So for this answer, negative, you will not take the negative, okay, answer may be negative, may be positive, but you will take the only positive value, okay. So your answer y is equal to plus 6, okay, because why we are not taking negative the question, suppose you are measuring the length of rod, you know that the rod of the length, it will be never negative. You are measuring anything in this condition, it will be never negative, okay. So we are taking the positive value, okay. So that is the answer they have asked in GATE 2018. Now the second question, we are taking the second question. Now the second question, very very simple, this question, it has come in GATE. He is asking dy by dx, okay, is equal to minus x upon y to power n, okay, for n is equal to 1, minus 1 and 1. This is, he is asking that this is circle, this is circle, our hyperbola. Then he is asking, this is hyperbola circle, hyperbola and circle. Then he is asking hyperbola, parabola, hyperbola and parabola. Then he is asking parabola and circle, parabola and circle, parabola and circle, okay. This question, it has come in your GATE 2018, okay. You have to just focus this question. This is a very very simple question, okay. How to solve it? At first I am placing n, okay. At first you have n is equal to minus 1, then you have n is equal to 1. I will place n is equal to minus 1, okay, in this differential equation, okay. So you have dy by dx is equal to minus x upon y to power 1 or minus 1, sorry, because we have placed minus 1. He has given you n is equal to minus 1 and 1. So in this condition, it will be minus y upon x, okay. Okay, because of minus 1, you know that 1 upon x is equal to x to power minus 1, okay. So same thing also we have done. Now, we will use the separable of variable. We will use this separable of variable again. So we will separate, okay. This y will come here. Y into dy is equal to dx will come here. Sorry. Okay, sorry. We have this result. Your y, this y will come here. Then your answer, it will be dy upon y is equal to, this x will come here, minus dx upon x. Okay. Now you will integrate. You can see that dy upon y. Dy upon y is equal to log y is equal to minus log x plus log c. Okay. Y you have taken log c. This is the constant. Okay. You can take any value. Okay, here we have taken log c. Okay, so now it will come here. Then your log y plus log x is equal to log c. Okay, log m plus log n is equal to log m into n. Log y x is equal to log c. Now here also log, here also log. We take the constant because of we are to get a relevant answer, okay. So we can replace it, then after then your answer, it will be yx is equal to c, okay. Your answer is yx is equal to c. Now c is the constant, c is the constant, so you can take any value in place of c. C is the constant, so you can take any value in place of C. Let we are taking C is equal to 1, it should totally depend on you again, okay. So now it means that Y is equal to 1 upon X, the graph of 1 upon X is like this, okay. If you know how to plot the graph, then you can also solve it. So that is the hyperbola, that is the hyperbola. It means that if this is the hyperbola in this condition, your answer is wrong, this answer is wrong, okay. Because he is asking, in if you will put n is equal to minus 1, then it must be hyperbola. So here you are getting hyperbola. Now we have to check this. If you will put n is equal to 1, then it will be represent parabola or circle, okay. Now if n is equal to 1, then what will happen? We will check dy by dx, dy by dx is equal to minus x upon y ki power 1. This time in place of n we have written 1, so this time you have dy by dx, okay. Now we will use the separable of variable again. So your y, it will come here in this condition, y dy is equal to dx, it will come here minus x dx. Now integrate both sides, then you will get y square upon 2 is equal to minus x square upon 2 plus c square upon 2. You can take any value, it should only depend on you. This is the constant, you can put any value, 2, 3, 5, any value, okay. So now it will come here, and you can also multiply by 2 both sides. In this condition you will get y square plus x square is equal to c square, okay. That is the circle, you can see that. This is the equation of circle, x square plus y square is equal to r square. That is the equation of circle. It means that your answer is this, okay. This question, it has come in your gate. They have asked from the variable of separable, okay. Now the third question, now that is enough for any exam. I will suggest to everyone, for any exam put the concept in your memory, okay. It is better put the concept in your memory. If you are solving more questions, okay, the more you will solve, more you will puzzle, okay. Don't puzzle, you put the concept in your memory, okay. And after then, you will crack the exam. That is very simple. Now the second topic, whenever just you are walking on the street, then you must think about, okay, today our teacher, they taught us this topic and you must discuss with your friends. That is the way to put the data in your memory, okay. And every time, even also you are just going to the inside the toilet, you can also think about this lecture, okay. And if you are just using you are sleeping in your dream also, you can also think about the topic. That can possible, that is very simple. So that is the way to get success. So now here, now the second one is the linear form. What is the linear form? Whenever you have this form, any differential equation will be this form, dy by dx plus py is equal to q. If you have any function just like this, then you will say that this is the linear form, okay. What is p and what is q? P and q are the function of x. P and q are the function of x, okay. P and q are the function of x, then you will say that such type of differential equation is the linear form. Now we are taking an example. What will be the solution? Your solution, it will be your integrating factor. In this time you will get integrating factor e to the power integration of p dx. Whatever you have got, your solution is y is equal to e into integrating factor integration of q into integrating factor plus c. This is your solution. What is this? Okay, suppose you have this example. Suppose you have this example, dy by dx plus x into y is equal to x square. Okay, this is also x, no problem. Suppose you have such type of differential equation. That is linear, very simple. That is linear because of this also, this same p is equal to, you have x and q is equal to also x. Now, at first you have to find the integrating factor. Integrating factor is equal to e to the power integration p dx. P is x, x dx. In this condition, your answer, it will be x means x square upon 2, e to the power x square upon 2, okay. Your integrating factor is this. In this condition, your answer is y into इंटीग्रेटिंग फैक्टर, वाई इंटू इंटीग्रेटिंग फैक्टर, इंटीग्रेटिंग फैक्टर इज ई टू द पावर एक्स स्क्वायर अपॉन टू इज इक्वल टू इंटीग्रेशन क्यू, क्यू इज एक्स एक्स इंटीग्रेटिंग फैक्टर इज दिस ई टू द पावर एक्स स्क्वायर अपॉन टू प्लस सी, दिस इज योर आंसर, वेरी वेरी सिंपल. नाउ आई विल सॉल्व वन गेट क्वेश्चन, ओके आई एम जस्ट इरेजिंग इट. ओके सो दिस इज अ वेरी सिंपल, यू हैव टू पुट एवरीथिंग इन योर मेमोरी. द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इट हैज कम इन योर गेट एग्जाम, दिस क्वेश्चन आई एम टेकिंग द इनिशियल वैल्यू प्रॉब्लम. ओके या द इनिशियल वैल्यू प्रॉब्लम x into dy by dx plus is equal to y plus x square, x is greater than 0 and y 0 is equal to 0, y 0 is equal to 0 has number first infinite solution. I am solving also this topic, infinite solution, no solution, unique solution, these are very important. Okay, you must focus on this question because same question it has come in your gate exam. So now the first question he is asking, infinite solution, question number B, two solution, question number C, unique solution, and question number D, no solution. Very simple. Okay, so this question it has come. Okay, at first we will check that what type of differential equation is this. Okay, at first we will check. So you have this one, we will put here. So your dy by dx is equal to y upon x plus x be divided by x. Okay, now it will come here, your dy by dx minus y upon x is equal to x, this is linear, where p is equal to minus 1 upon x and q is equal to x, this is the linear differential equation where p is equal to this. Your integrating factor is equal to e to the power integration minus 1 upon x dx, in this condition 1 upon x integration of 1 upon x is equal to log x. Okay, so e to the power minus log x. Okay, now this power, it means that this is e to the power log 1 upon x. You must remember e to the power log x is equal to x, it means that this will be 1 upon x, this is the answer, your integrating factor is 1 upon x. Now you will put this 1 upon x, you will multiply 1 upon x with y. So now y into integrating factor, I am using this y into integrating factor is 1 upon x, y into integrating factor is equal to integration q. What about q? Q is x into integrating factor 1 upon x into integrating factor plus c, this is your answer. Okay, now if you solve it, then you are getting y upon x is equal to this, cancel x and x, then after that you are getting constant here, you will also write dx. Okay, here also you will write dx. Okay, actually if they have given us the variable is x, then you will write x, otherwise you will write another variable. Okay, so here x and x cancel, then this will be x plus c, this is the answer, this is your answer. It means that your answer is this, y is equal to x square plus cx, this is your answer. Now he has given us y0 is equal to 0. Your y is 0 whenever you are placing in place of x is equal to 0. Okay, by the help of boundary value problem, these are the boundary value problem. If by the help of boundary value problem here, if we are not able to get the c, here you can see that 0 is equal to 0 plus c into 0 is equal to 0. Okay, so it is not possible to find c. Okay, that is impossible. in this condition you will say that such type of solution has infinite number of solution. Whenever by the help of, again remember it, whenever by the help of boundary value condition it is not possible to, you are getting just like this, c into 0 is equal to 0. It is not possible to find c, okay, c means a constant, okay. So in this condition you will say that such type of differential equation has infinite number of solution. It means that you can put in place of c anything, it's totally depend on you. If you will put c 1, then after then its differential equation is different. Put 3, then after then the differential equation it will be different. So for different conditions of c, your differential equation it will be also changes, okay. So there are infinite number of solutions, you have to remember it, okay. Again I am just solving same question. If you have any doubt in this question, then I will solve. This topic we have done, now I am just coming in this topic, this topic we have done, now we are coming in no solution and unique solution. What is the meaning of unique solution and what is the meaning of no solution? I am erasing it, okay. These all question it has come in your GATE exam. The second question we are taking, this question it has also come in your GATE exam, okay. I am not writing everything, okay. You must remember all the logic in your memory, okay. That will help to crack the exam. So this is dy by dx is equal to, he has written 2y ki power 1 upon 2, y0 is equal to 0. This time the boundary value condition they have given us, and he is asking what about this. Now again we will use variable of separable, okay. So this it will come here, y ki power 1 upon 2, and this is 2dx, so it will come here, then after then y ki power minus 1 upon 2, dy is equal to 2dx. Now you have to integrate both sides. In this condition your answer it will be minus 1 upon 2 plus 1 upon minus 1 upon 2 plus 1 is equal to 2x plus c. Your answer is this. Now you have to solve it. In this condition your answer will be 1 upon 2, this is 1 upon 2, okay, and this is also 1 upon 2, it means that 2 will come here, and 2x plus c, okay, this is your answer. Okay, so now he has given us y0 is equal to 0. If we'll put in place of x 0, then your answer it will be 0, means y is equal to 0. So y is 0, okay, 2 into 0, when you are putting 0 in place of x, then this c, okay, this is, it means that you are getting c is equal to 0, you are getting c is equal to 0. So here you have a value, okay, in this condition. Don't think that the previous question and this question both are same, both are not same. Just focus here, here you have 0 is equal to 0 plus c into 0, okay. In this question it is not possible to find a c, but where we have got a c, that is 0. This and this both are different, you must note it, both are not same, okay. So here we are getting c is equal to 0. Whenever you are getting c is equal to 0, it means that you can say that it has solution exists, okay. You can say that solution exists but not uniquely, solution exists but not uniquely, okay. Means a finite number of solution, finite number of solution. So this is the second question. Third question again I am taking about, we are just thinking about what about no solution, okay. What about no solution, okay. Now I am just erasing it again. Whenever you are getting exact value of c, in this condition you can say that maybe it has unique solution, okay. In this condition you can say, but if you are getting c is equal to 0, in this condition we cannot say, okay, c is 0, okay, I don't know, it has finite number of, means it has many solution, finite number of solutions. Now second, third question it has come in also GATE 2008, this question, this question it has come also in GATE. All question we have taken from the GATE. Okay, we research on all questions, and we have here we are solving only the important question, not all the questions. That is impossible. Okay, so the question is dy/dx is equal to y square. Y square, y0 is equal to 1. Y0 is equal to 1. And he is asking, the first one is, it has solution, okay. X belong to minus infinite to 1. He has given us this interval. Then after then, he has asking, x belong to minus infinite to infinite, okay. Then C, he is asking, x belong to 0 to infinite, 0 to A, 0 to A, okay. And A is greater than 1. And D, he is asking x belong to 1 to A, and A is greater than 1. He is asking this question. Now, this question, solution exists. He is asking that solution exists. For which condition the solution it will be exist. So again, we will solve, we will use the separable of variable again, the first one. We are just okay. Now it means that dy upon y square is equal to dx. Okay, this will come here in this condition, y ki power minus 2 dy is equal to dx. So you have to solve it. You will get y ki power minus 2 plus 1 upon minus 2 plus 1 is equal to x plus c. Now solve it. You will get minus 1 upon y is equal to x plus c. This is your solution. Okay. But they have given us, okay. So they have given us, what they have given us? Y 0 is equal to 1. They have given us y 0 is equal to 1. So if you will put x is equal to 0, then your y is equal to 1. It means that minus 1 upon 1 is equal to 0 plus c. It means that c is equal to minus 1. Okay. Your answer, it will be minus 1 upon y is equal to x, c is equal to minus 1, minus 1. This is your answer. Okay. If it will come here, then it will come here. In this condition, your y is equal to, it will come here, minus 1 upon x minus 1. You can also write y is equal to 1 upon 1 minus x. Okay. You know that in this condition, if I will put x is equal to 1, in this condition your y is equal to infinite, 1 upon 0 is undefined. Okay, so your x is equal to 1 is not the solutions exist. It means he is asking that solution exists for what condition of x your solution exists. So if x is equal to 1, then there will be no solution. Okay, when x is equal to 1, then there will be no solution. Now you can check that, where is 1? You know that this is minus infinite to infinite. It means that in this interval, 1 is belonging. So this is wrong. Okay. Now here you also 0 to A, and A is greater than 1. It means that here also 1 is also belonging. So this is not answer. Okay. This is 1 to A, and A is greater than 1, and 1 is also belonging, because this is the closed interval. It means that 1 is here. If they will write open interval in this condition, this is also answer. But this is not the answer, because 1, it is inside the closed interval. Okay. This here, they have given the open interval, minus infinite to 1. It means that 1 is not in this interval. It means that your answer is this. Okay. For x is equal to 1, there is no solution. The solution never exists. Okay. So this is... this question, it has also come in your GATE exam. You must focus on this topic, infinite solution, no solution, and unique solution. This is very, very important. Now I am just talking about another topic. These topic they have not asked in your GATE exam, but again I will write something how to solve such type of question. The first one is reducible to linear form. Okay, reducible to linear form. So your question, your topic, it will be like this. I will take only little bit, 5 minutes. Okay, that is sufficient these five topics that these five topics are sufficient to clear this topic, okay, this differential equation part. Okay, the first one, reducible to linear form. Whenever you have such form, dy by dx, okay, plus p y is equal to q y to power n. How to transform this equation to linear form? In this condition, it will come here. 1 upon y to power n dy by dx plus p upon y to power n y, okay, and is equal to y to power n minus 1. It has come here, and q. Now we have to transfer this equation to linear form. Linear form means dy by dx plus py is equal to q. If we will transfer this equation to this form, then after then we can solve. That is very simple. I will not explain everything. I will only explain by the help of one example. I am taking one example. This question, it has come in your exam. Dy by dx, okay, plus y upon x is equal to y square upon x square. This question, very very simple. Okay, so in this condition, this will come here. This y square will come here. So 1 upon y square dy by dx plus this is 1 upon y into 1 upon x is equal to 1 upon x square. What we have done, this y square we divided by y square, left hand row, right side. So 1 upon y square, so y and y cancel, 1 upon y, and we separate also it. Now we will do something. Okay, if I will write here this 1 upon y is equal to v, let 1 upon y is equal to v. In this condition, we have to differentiate both sides. So y to power minus 1 is equal to v. In this condition, minus 1 y to power minus 1 minus 1 dy is equal to dv upon dx. With respect to x, we differentiate. Or you can say also dy by dx. In this condition, your minus 1 upon y square dy by dx, okay, is equal to dv upon dx. We can also write 1 upon y square dy by dx is equal to minus dv upon dx. Okay, now I am erasing it, this question, this topic. The second topic here, you have now in place of this, you have to write this one. So minus dv upon dx, okay, plus 1 upon y is equal to v, 1 upon y is equal to v upon x, and is equal to 1 upon x square. Now this is your, just like, now you will multiply both sides by minus dv upon dx minus v upon x is equal to minus 1 upon x square. This is the linear form. Now you can see that this is the linear form, just like this equation, just like dy by dx plus py is equal to q, where p is the function of x, q is the function of x. Here p is equal to minus 1 upon x and q is equal to minus 1 upon x square. You can see q is equal to minus 1 upon x square and p is equal to minus 1 upon x. This is v and this is v, and this is y and this is y, both are same. Okay, so in this condition, your answer e is equal to integration of p dx. Okay, e is equal to integration of, what about p? P is equal to minus 1 upon x, minus 1 upon x dx, minus 1 upon x is equal to log x, e to the power minus log x. Okay, so this is 1 upon x, e to the power log 1 upon x, and this is log cancel, so this is 1 upon x. This is your integrating factor. Okay, so your integrating factor is this. In this condition, your solution, in this condition, your solution, in this condition, your solution, your solution is this, v into integrating factor is equal to integration of q. What is q? Q is this minus 1 upon x square integrating factor plus c. Okay, already we have discussed on this topic. So now v, okay, after then you will put also what is v. Okay, at last, integrating factor is 1 upon x and is equal to integration of minus 1 upon x square. This is also 1 upon x and dx plus c. Now you have to integrate it and you will get the solution. And at last you will put in place of v, you will put what you have taken, v is equal to 1 upon y. At last you have to put, then you will get the solution. So this is the way to find the, all the solutions. Already we have also covered this one. So what about the homogeneous form? That is the very biggest form. Okay. And whenever you are getting homogeneous form, in this condition you will take like this, v is equal to y upon x. Okay. Here we are just not discussing. Okay. In the next lecture we will discuss on this topic. If you will find any question that has come in your GATE exam, then after that we will discuss on this topic also. So this is also very simple homogeneous form. Homogeneous means both are same. If you want, we will explain one question. The first question we will explain. Okay, we are erasing it. What is the homogeneous form? Again we will explain. So suppose you have this one, okay, 2xy plus x square into y dash is equal to 3y square plus 2xy, okay, this. Now we can write this one dy by dx. Now you can see that why we are just talking homogeneous. Homogeneous means form are same. Here degree is same. You can see that 1 plus 1 is equal to 2, and this is also 2, and this is also 2, and this is 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. So that is the homogeneous form. Okay. So now we are writing 2xy plus x square. This is dy by dx is equal to 3y square plus 2xy. Okay. This will come here. In this condition, your dy by dx is equal to 3y square plus 2xy upon this 2xy plus x square. If we'll divide this one, if we'll divide by x square, if we'll divide by x square here, and if we'll divide by x square here, then let us, we will check what will happen. So in this condition, 3y upon x whole square plus 2y upon x. Okay, now this is 2y upon x and this is 1. We divided by x square both side. Now we are taking, let y is equal to y upon x is equal to v. Y upon x is equal to v. Okay, then you will differentiate. You will differentiate this one, dv upon dx is equal to, okay, you will differentiate this one, then after then 1 plus dv upon dx. Okay, so in place of this you have to differentiate it.